Welcome back to the NExT appraisal modules. This module is part two of the introduction and covers the topic of how to appraise. Now that you've watched part one and understand why to appraise, let's jump into discussing how one appraises the evidence. In order to be knowledgeable consumers of research, nurses are required to be able to read, understand, and appraise the level and quality of evidence. This takes some practice and development of a set of acquired skills. As a reader learns to appraise the typical elements found in a research report, it becomes part of their normal evidence reading skill. Initially, though, it will take being patient with yourself and at times working through certain elements with which you are less familiar. Repeated exposure to reports of primary original research and working through what to look for in reading those reports will be of the utmost value. The first key to appraising the evidence is to consistently use a standard approach. Using a standardized process like an appraisal tool will facilitate a methodical format of appraising the same key elements across various pieces of evidence. In appraising those elements of a scientific report, we are looking for the strengths and weaknesses that are present in every report. No perfect study or written report exists. As a reader, you are identifying the areas you feel are clearly described or lacking, and then use this to appraise that report. Again, all studies have weaknesses, and the fact that they are published as an article shouldn't be interpreted to mean that they constitute strong quality evidence. Keep this in mind as you learn to appraise. The objective for appraisal is not to develop criticism of anyone's work, but to guide you through a methodical approach to reading and learning about the key elements. A novice appraiser will begin to develop enhanced understanding over time and feel more comfortable. Just don't give up or feel frustrated if a particular area is more challenging. Seek resources and just simply give it your best. Discussion of the appraisal is always strengthened when discussed in a group, like a journal club, or with others. So don't be afraid to engage with someone during your process of learning to appraise the evidence. For the purpose of these NExT EBP appraisal modules, we will be specifically discussing the elements found in a primary quantitative research article. A primary quantitative research article is a report of an original research project that collected numeric information and was conducted by the persons writing the report. We highly encourage you to identify a primary quantitative research article, read through it entirely, and have it available to work through as you progress along these appraisal modules. We feel this will provide you the best opportunity to understanding this material. If you've already found that primary quantitative research report, quickly take a look through the major headings. Most scientific articles follow a very specific sequencing of the reported information, known as the MRAD format. On this slide, you see that the MRAD format includes the introduction, followed by the methods section, and then the results and discussion sections. This format provides a very logical sequence and a flow of the information being presented in the article. An abstract often is provided before the actual body of the report and gives a brief synopsis of what will be provided in these sections. As you work through the appraisal modules, we will identify where we typically find the information being reported and will refer you to those sections identified using the MRAD format. Here are some examples of existing appraisal tools. Each vary in their simplicity or complexities. There are a range of appraisal tools which vary from yes or no closed answer type of responses to a more narrative, open response to the elements of appraisal. Again, the objective is to use a standardized approach by identifying strengths and weaknesses, determination of clinical usefulness, and the quality or level of evidence. You may even work in an organization that has either developed their own or has elected to use a specific appraisal tool. Regardless, the principles of appraisal, which we will be covering in these modules, are designed to provide you the basic understanding of appraisal and should be helpful with any appraisal tool. For the purpose of this EBP course, and specifically the appraisal modules, we have adapted and designed our own appraisal tool. If you have not yet located the tool on the website, it is important that you pause this module and locate it before continuing into the rest of the appraisal modules. The next 25 modules will directly follow the questions of our appraisal tool. You will find it to be most useful to have an available version of the NExT appraisal tool either in hand or opened electronically as you continue to progress along the series of modules. For using the appraisal tool to complete with any primary quantitative research report, it would be simplest to complete it electronically. The appraisal tool we have adapted is to be used with a primary quantitative research report. Although we do often refer to the different elements found in a qualitative report, this tool is specific to use with a single quantitative research report. Literature reviews, opinion pieces, systematic reviews, and other non-quantitative research pieces will not necessarily align with the appraisal questions discussed in the next 25 modules. This slide provides what the beginning of the tool looks like. Again, we highly recommend that you have a paper or electronic version available as you work through the modules. In each of the following 25 modules, we will take every question from the NExT appraisal tool and provide a basic description of the information that the author should be reporting. Each video module will begin with the numbered appraisal question and identify where the content is typically found in an article. The components of that appraisal question are then discussed. Subsequently, then an example from an article related to what an author might write is provided. Lastly, examples of how to potentially formulate an appraisal response are then provided. If you are following along with your own selected article and having fully read the article before starting the modules, you may elect to pause after each module to formulate your appraisal response to the article you're reading. The modules are designed in an attempt to be user-friendly and easily facilitate the process if you need to return later and review any particular question on the NExT appraisal tool, or simply brush up on your understanding of how to appraise any specific area of an article. To make the most of appraising any article, we recommend the following. Print out the article. Read the article thoroughly before beginning to appraise it. Go back and begin to work through the appraisal questions. Answer the questions comprehensively with well-developed responses. This certainly makes for easier comparison against other articles. Then consider a summarizing strategy, like summarizing each article as you go with writing the key elements of that article into a summary table. This is discussed in the final appraisal module. Congratulations! You have successfully completed part two of the introduction modules and should be ready to progress to the appraisal tool modules. You may return to the main menu or continue directly to those appraisal modules in the NExT EBP course.